In this video, we will talk about the uses of adrenergic drugs. Let's get started. As per the name, these drugs activate one or more of the adrenergic functions. They have a wide range of uses across multiple organ systems. Let's start with the cardiovascular system, where first we will see the uses in hypotensive conditions. Adrenergic drugs are commonly used in shock or acute hypotension. Shock is a state of decreased tissue perfusion due to a drastic fall in blood pressure. Here our goal is to increase blood pressure so that perfusion is restored. Agents with both alpha and beta actions should be used under such conditions. The reason is that if the drug has only alpha action, it will cause vasoconstriction. Now, the increased vascular tone and blood pressure are beneficial, but there can be a decrease in cardiac output and impairment of tissue perfusion. On the other hand, selective beta agonists cause cardiac stimulation and vasodilatation. This increases blood flow, but at the same time, there would be risk of myocardial ischemia. Thus, there are disadvantages to using selective drugs. A drug that acts on both types of receptors produces balanced action. So they are preferred. For example, noradrenaline. It mainly has alpha action. The vasoconstriction produced by it balances vasodilatation by beta receptors. And beta-1-mediated cardiac stimulation helps maintain cardiac output, which balances the tendency to decrease cardiac output by alpha receptors. Thus, balanced action is produced. Other drugs that can be used are methamphetamine and phenylephrine. This was some general discussion about shock. Now let's talk about a few specific types of shocks. First, cardiogenic shock. Here the reason for poor tissue perfusion is poor pumping by the heart. Dobutamine and dopamine at low to moderate doses stimulate beta-1 receptors. The resultant positive ionotropy helps the heart pump more blood. Dopamine has additional action on dopaminergic receptors as well. This causes renal vasodilatation, which improves renal blood flow. So this was about cardiogenic shock. Now let's talk about anaphylactic shock. This is an allergic reaction. Adrenaline is life-saving in this condition. It increases blood pressure, counteracts bronchospasm, and counteracts laryngeal edema. In neurogenic shock, there is a loss of sympathetic vasoconstrictor tone. Resultant vasodilatation causes hypotension and decreased tissue perfusion. Methamphetamine and ephedrine can be used in this situation. They cause vasoconstriction and also counteract bradycardia. So this was all about shock. Now let's see the next use, chronic orthostatic hypotension. This is hypotension occurring on standing up from sitting or lying down posture. When you stand up, normally the reflex control by the heart increases blood pressure. This helps maintain cerebral perfusion. But in conditions where reflex control is lost, for example, autonomic neuropathy, there won't be this adjustment. So gravitational pooling of blood produces hypotension and decreased cerebral perfusion. This results in dizziness and sometimes fainting. To treat this, we can use drugs with alpha action, like midodrine, ephedrine, phenylephrine, and methamphetamine. A newer agent, droxidopa, is a prodrug that is converted to noradrenaline in the body. These drugs increase peripheral resistance, which helps maintain blood pressure and thereby cerebral perfusion. However, this is a general action, and they do not exactly mimic the reflex that occurs on standing up. So these were the uses in hypotensive conditions. Now let's talk about uses where local vasoconstriction is needed. Starting with control of local bleeding from the skin and mucous membrane, for example, epistaxis, surgery, or trauma-related bleeding. Adrenaline is used in epistaxis, and noradrenaline is used in gastric erosion and stress ulcers. Cocaine is sometimes used in nasopharyngeal surgery because of additional local anesthetic action. So this was about local bleeding. Next, with local anesthetic agents. Epinephrine is added with local anesthetics for several benefits that it offers. Local vasoconstriction produced by epinephrine prevents the spread of anesthetic in the systemic circulation. So the anesthetic agent stays local, which increases its effect and also decreases the required dose of anesthetic. Also, systemic toxicity is decreased. For this purpose, epinephrine is used in 1 in 200,000 dilution. So this was use with a local anesthetic agent. Now let's talk about the uses of adrenergic drugs as nasal decongestants. As decongestants, they are used for colds, rhinitis, sinusitis, and blocked nose or eustachian tubes. Drugs commonly used for this indication are naphazoline, xylometazoline, oxymetazoline, and phenylephrine. Now, there are several disadvantages of these nasal decongestants. First, once their effect wears, there is rebound hyperemia. On prolonged use, ischemia leads to atrophy of mucosa. Infants and young children are more sensitive to the central effects of imidazolines, which include naphazoline, xylometazoline, and oxymetazoline. So in these groups, they should be used in low concentration. Also, they should be used cautiously in hypertensive patients and elderly males. So these were all the uses for local vasoconstriction. Now let's talk about cardiac uses. First, cardiac arrest. Cardiac arrest means the heart has stopped beating. Here, adrenaline given intravenously, along with external cardiac massage, can save the patient. Next, AV block. In this, the impulse conduction is impaired at the AV node. Isoprenaline can be used temporarily to maintain ventricular rate. Next, congestive heart failure. Though we are discussing, adrenergic drugs are not used routinely for this indication. However, dopamine or dobutamine may be used to overcome acute cardiac decompensation during myocardial infarction, cardiac surgery, and in resistant CHF for a short term. Now the last cardiac use, the dobutamine stress test. This is done in patients who are not able to perform physical exercise to find out the ischemic area in the heart. For this, dobutamine is infused intravenously at an increasing rate. This stimulates the heart by its beta-1 action. So there is an increase in heart rate and cardiac workload. Because of this increased workload, the ischemic area is exposed, which is identified with electrocardiography or nuclear medicine techniques. So these were all the uses in the cardiovascular system. Now let's move into the respiratory system. Here, adrenergic drugs are used in bronchial asthma and COPD. Beta-2 stimulant agents like albuterol, terbutaline, and salmeterol cause bronchodilatation and help patients breathe. That is it for pulmonary uses. Now let's see the uses in the eye. Phenylephrine is used for fundus examination. It dilates the pupil that clears the view to see the fundus. The advantage of using phenylephrine is that it does not produce cycloplegia, so accommodation is not compromised. In allergic conjunctivitis, it decongests conjunctiva and is also used to localize the lesion in Horner's syndrome. Next, glaucoma. Here, alpha agonist drugs are used. Dipivefrin is occasionally used as an adjunctive medication in open-angle glaucoma. Apraclonidine and brimonidine are selective alpha-2 agonists used as the second-line add-on drug with topical prostaglandin analogs or beta blockers. So these were ocular uses. Next, as uterine relaxants, adrenergic drugs can be used to postpone labor and in threatened abortion. To postpone labor, ritodrine may be used. During pregnancy, the number of beta-2 receptors increases in the uterus, and its stimulation by adrenergic drugs relaxes the uterus. However, there is a risk of maternal cardiac and metabolic complications and pulmonary embolism. In threatened abortion, isoxaprin can be used, but its efficacy is doubtful. These were uterine uses. Now the allergic disorders. In most allergic reactions, histamine plays a major role, and the adrenaline is a physiological antagonist of histamine. This makes adrenaline a very good drug for many allergic reactions, like laryngeal edema, anaphylaxis, urticaria, and angioedema. The useful actions from adrenaline are vasoconstriction, cardiac stimulation, and bronchodilatation. However, it is not effective in delayed and other types of allergic reactions where histamine is not a major mediator. So this was about the use of adrenaline in allergic disorders. Now let's move to the next system, the central nervous system. Central uses include attention deficit hyperkinetic disorder, or ADHD for short, and narcolepsy. ADHD is common in children and is associated with hyperkinetic physical behavior, short attention span, and learning problem. Amphetamines increase attention span. This improves behavior and study performance. But the reduction in appetite may lead to growth retardation. In general, it is better not to use amphetamine. Methylphenidate is similar to amphetamine, but produces fewer side effects and less growth retardation. It is now preferred. Atomoxetine is a noradrenaline uptake blocker. It also has a better tolerability profile and is preferred. This was ADHD. Narcolepsy is a sleep disorder associated with excessive daytime drowsiness. Amphetamines can help with this, but there is a risk of development of tolerance and abuse, as well as behavioral abnormalities. Modafinil, on the other hand, has less chance of dependence, produces fewer behavioral adverse effects, and is preferred now. So these are the central uses. Now let's quickly see some additional uses of adrenergic drugs. Clonidine can be used in hypertension where it acts as a central sympatholytic. It can also be used in diarrhea in diabetics with autonomic neuropathy, for menopausal hot flushes, and to decrease craving for narcotics, alcohol, and cigarette smoking. Dexmedetomidine is used for sedation in intensive care circumstances and during anesthesia. It blunts a sympathetic response to surgery, and it lowers opioid requirements for pain control and does not depress ventilation. Tizanidine is an alpha-2 agonist and can be used as a central muscle relaxant. And finally, in insulin hypoglycemia, adrenaline may be used in extreme cases if glucagon is not available. However, this is associated with so many side effects. So these were all the uses of adrenergic drugs. Now let's have a quick summary. Adrenergic drugs are used in shock, chronic orthostatic hypotension, to control local bleeding from the skin and mucous membrane, along with local anesthetics, as nasal decongestants, in cardiac arrest, AV block, congestive heart failure, dobutamine stress test, bronchial asthma and COPD, fundus examination, allergic conjunctivitis, localize the lesion in Horner's syndrome, glaucoma, to postpone labor, threatened abortion, allergic disorders like laryngeal edema, anaphylaxis, urticaria and angioedema, ADHD, narcolepsy, and these few more uses. That's it for this video. You can find notes and explore our entire animation video library at our website. The links are in the description. If you like our content, please share it with your friends and colleagues to support us. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.